A capacitance of a spherical conductor. Please welcome to TIS. This simple task we're going to take here. We have a question with us. Show that for a cylindrical capacitor C consisting of two long coaxial cylinders of length L of radii A, that is for the inner cylinder, and B for the outer cylinder, the ratio of P to A is equal to P out of A, then is equal to exponential 2 pi times permittivity times length out of C. That is the capacitance. So we can just start with a simple sketch of how our question looks like diagrammatically. So it is something of this kind. Then we can just say this is the Gaussian surface here, and then we say this is P, the larger radius, and then of course to A we say this is A, that is the inner radius. So of course we say that now Gaussian surface encloses the central cylinder, so the charge and magnetic field are related by the equation. We are always aware that the electric field is given by kq out of r squared, which is equal to k out of 4 pi permittivity. We know that k is given by 1 out of 4 pi times permittivity, and of course we add our radius squared here. So in making Q the subject, we obtain that this electric field times 4 pi permittivity, and then radius squared, and therefore we can be able to know that Q is given by 4 pi and then r squared, that is the area. So this is the electric field times permittivity times the area. So the charge and electric field are also related by this equation. Having known that, we know that the curved part of a cylinder is obtained by 2 pi rl, the area. So our Q will be equal to permittivity times the electric field, and then of course instead of the area there's now 2 pi radius times length. Having known that, we know that 2 pi r is the area of the curved part of the Gaussian surface now, but now we also remember that at the ends or the cups of the cylinder there is no flux, and our equation reduces to electric field is Q out of 2 pi rl. So from the R equation that we did learn, we saw that the voltage is given by the integral, that's plus minus here, the electric field times the change in distance. Times the change in distance, and then thus the voltage will be given, now this is a constant, it will move out of 2 pi permittivity times the length, then the integral from A to P, and then of course dr out of S. This negative comes here as a result of it was ds, so we know that ds is equal to negative dr, so there's a negative that comes now outside here. So having known up to that point, that is of course we can say that we can note that where ds is equal to negative dr, since we have integrated radial inwards. So since we have integrated radial inwards, no need of writing that. And now we let us apply the definite integrals, the integral of 1 out of x is the ln of x, that is the natural logarithm of x, and therefore the voltage will be given by negative q out of 2 pi times permittivity. We have length, and then of course the natural logarithm of a minus natural logarithm of b. So the voltage is equal to negative q out of 2 pi permittivity length times length, then the natural logarithm of p out of a. So then, since we know that capacitance is given by Q out of phi, then capacitance will be equal to 2 pi times permittivity, then of course length out of the natural logarithm of A out of, in fact, P out of A. Now we want to show that from our question, we are showing this one, this relationship here. So in coming here, we can say times the L, that is the natural logarithm of P out of A, both sides, times here, times the natural logarithm of P out of A. So you can know that this one cancels out. Then we have the natural logarithm of P out of A is equal to 2 pi permittivity length out of capacitance. And therefore, we know that the natural logarithm and exponential are always related. They are always in the opposite. So P out of I, it will be able to be given by the exponential. This is 2 pi permittivity times length out of capacitance. And that after this point, I hope I've simplified this question. Please subscribe to this channel.